What are you looking at? You must have noticed that what you look at sometimes has a way of affecting your facial expression, attitude, or action. For instance, there are times when you look at someone who is laughing and you unconsciously begin to laugh. Also, you may look at something disgusting, or you look at someone who is sad or crying, and that sight evokes a reaction from you. Many times, people commit errors against God, against others, or even against themselves because of the things they are looking at or the things to which they are paying attention. But as Christians, there are certain things that we are not supposed to look at, focus on, dwell on, or have serious consideration for if we really want to please God. Galatians 6:10 says, "As we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who are of the household of faith." But if you want to consider how someone neglected or oppressed you when things were tough for you and rose for him, you would not want to do him good now that the tide has turned in your favor and against him. If you want to look at how little what you are earning is, you would not want to obey God's instruction in Malachi 3:10, "Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house." Some Christians do not like giving offerings or even paying their tithes because they have heard of pastors who have stolen money from their churches and they are afraid of someone taking money that they have labored for. But then Ecclesiastes 11:4 says, "He that observeth the wind shall not sow, and he that regardeth the clouds shall not reap." If you are refusing to give to God because of someone else, you are taking a wrong step because of what you are looking at. Why don't you fulfill your obligation to your God and leave him to judge the one who is stealing from the church purse? And don't forget that when you fail to sow, there will be nothing for you to reap. Some Christians like to give only to those who are in a position to give back to them. They look at the lives of the poor around them as an unfertile ground to sow into because they don't expect anything good to come out from seeds that are sown there. But then they forget what the Bible says in Proverbs 19:17. "He that hath pity on the poor lendeth unto the Lord, and that which he hath given will he pay him again." If you want to keep your focus on your neighbor's rude, selfish, and disrespectful attitude, you will not be able to fulfill the commandment to follow peace with all men, Hebrews 12:14. You would want to show him that you are not a fool who will take just anything that is dished out to him. If your attention is focused on how you feel when someone deliberately frames and gets you into trouble at work, and also on how happy that person is as he enjoys his victory over you, you will not obey the word of God in Proverbs 24:29. "Say not, I will do so to him as he has done to me. I will render to the man according to his work." As a child of God, you are not supposed to take vengeance into your hands, but wait for the Lord to vindicate you and punish the evil person. If you look at the way you feel at times, tired, sleepy, busy, and so on, you will want to stay at home when you should be in church, thereby going against God's instruction in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together. Some people also consider the fact that God has not granted them certain desires of their heart, and they see it as a reason not to serve him. Meanwhile, in 2 Timothy 4:2, Paul admonishes us to serve God in season, out of season. In other words, no matter the situation we are in, we should serve him. Again, if you look at the attitude of some other Christians to the things of God, you will not see why you should be actively involved in God's work. But you have to bear in mind always that every one of us will give account of himself to God, according to Romans 14:12. Christianity is an individual thing, so don't let anyone's negative attitude influence you. 2 Corinthians 4:18 says, "While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal." Stop looking at the behavior or attitude of people around you, your bank account, the way you feel, what God has not done for you, and so on. These are temporal things that will pass with this world. To be your best for God, you have to look at the things which are eternal. Jesus is eternal, and the Bible says in Hebrews 12:2 that we should look unto him. So, focus your attention on Jesus and strive with his help to be like him. The word of God is eternal. Remember what Jesus said in Mark 13:31, "Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away." So let your attention be focused on the word of God. Let the word direct your steps. As you look at the word of God and give it consideration in everything you do every day, instead of giving consideration to temporal things, your life will please him more and more. Be careful what you look at. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen.